Hey everyone, and welcome back to episode 37 of my Create Mod series. Now today I'm going to show you how to make a quarry with gantries. If you enjoy this video, feel free to like and subscribe as I make a ton of Create Mod content and you're not going to want to miss any of the videos. Now, for those of you guys that were in the live stream, I just want to say thank you so much. We spent hours working on this thing, and then I worked with a couple people inside of Discord to help me make this machine work. So I just want to say thank you guys so much for all of the support. This should work a lot better than my previous quarry design. It's going to be based off of a couple other people's designs, so I'll credit as many people as I can inside of the description. But this is going to be a block-by-block build. So without holding back anymore, let's jump into it. So everything inside of this chest is what you are going to need. Everything is going to be listed inside of the description. There's a couple new blocks and the new create blocks. You probably don't know everything. But a couple things to go over is you are going to need super glue. You cannot just work with a slime ball. You are going to need super glue. A wrench and a pickaxe is highly recommended. You will need it for one shape or form throughout the build. And I have two things of concrete. This is just going to be for our frequencies, so you can use any item in the game. I'm just using concrete because it'll stand out a little bit better. Other than that, there's some things that I've built in the back. I'll cover that as soon as I get into the area, but that's mostly for me, so I know where to place down some blocks. But other than that, let's grab the blocks. We'll get started. So to get started, all you need to do is just kind of find a flat area. We're going to build our machine kind of up in the air, and then it will just mine for us by going into the ground. So all you need to do is find a clear area. I've built a couple blocks off the ground here just as a base. You can just see it's a 3x2 and then a little platform for me to walk up. And then on top of this platform, all we're going to do is take our linear chassis, and we just want to build up, if I can place them correctly. We want to build up so we have two chassis stacked on top of each other, and then remove one. And we're just going to place the rest of these linear chassis to build basically a little base for us. Now, this is where we're going to also attach our drills to it. So this is going to be our drilling platform that's going to be going up and down. So I'm just taking our glue, and I'm just gluing the bottom of this frame. And then with that, we just need to take our drills, and we just need to place our mechanical drills so that they're all facing downward. And some of these might be a little tricky, like this one, to place, so just use your wrench to rotate them. And then if I continue to rotate these guys, once they're all placed and they're all glued, we now have our drills attached to our chassis. So we'll just go ahead and hop on up. Now, on top of this platform, you're going to want to be careful on what you glue and what you don't glue. So what we're going to do is in this back left-hand corner, and if you needed a perspective, this is the platform where we walked up on. This spot right here, we're going to take a rope pulley and place it on top. Do not glue the rope pulley to the frame. The rest of these blocks, we can actually glue. So just like so. And we're going to take an observer and we're going to place it against this rope pulley with the red dot facing on the outside. Then we're also going to take a redstone link, place that onto that observer. We're going to grab one of our filters. I'm going to use my light blue concrete. And we're going to go ahead and set the filter by just right-clicking on both of these frequencies. And we're going to go ahead and refer to that frequency a little bit later towards the end of this video. So now that we've done that, we got to go ahead and fool around with some redstone contacts, which can be a little bit tricky, especially for newer players. So we're going to go ahead and place down a redstone contact, and you want to make sure that this red mark is facing towards the outside. Now remember, this is glued into this platform, but the other one that we're going to place is going to be on the outside, so you should see them glow red once they connect to each other. We want to make sure this is not glued to the platform itself. So when these redstone contacts come in contact with each other, it will give a redstone pulse, and that's what we're looking for. So we're going to go ahead and put a redstone link on the outside of this redstone contact. Now, that being said, we also want to do something by super gluing the outside of this redstone contact and then placing the redstone link on here. And then we're going to set it to the opposite frequency. So I'm going to set this to orange. All right, as you can see, they're set to orange. Now, one other thing that we want to do is what we're doing is making this platform that's going to go up and down, but we need a type of platform to stay up here. So currently, the things that are not locked into the platform is this redstone link, this redstone contact, and this rope pulley. So what we're going to do here is we're going to super glue on this redstone contact, super glue on this rope pulley. You could probably get away with one, but we'll just use two. We're going to take a vertical gearbox and place that here. So now this is all connected to one machine, this redstone contact, this vertical gearbox, and this rope pulley. And we're going to go ahead and build off of this in a moment. So one thing we can do, though, is take a small cogwheel and just place it on top of that vertical gearbox. We want to super glue the top of this vertical gearbox, then place a cogwheel, and we'll refer to that a little bit later towards the end of this video. All right, so I've gone up onto a platform that I've built that's just a couple blocks off the ground. It lines up perfectly with these linear chassis, and I've realized that we've run into a slight issue. So I figure we'll take care of this really quickly. If you go ahead and aim at one of these linear chassis with a wrench, hold down left control, and then you want to turn all of these guys down to 1. So you can see that this one was actually set to 11, others are set to 8. Make sure they're all set to 1. This will solve some problems in the future. And we can also take some chests, and we're just going to place down our chests just like so. So this will actually store our items when it's mining. And then once we come over here, we're going to do a little bit of a trick by basically going one block away, going 1, 2, 3, 4, and we're going to place down a clutch. And the clutch we want to have facing, so the gearbox is facing towards the back and towards the front. And then we'll place a gear shift in front of that, grab a lever, place it on top of the clutch, and flick it. This is going to power off our machine until we want it to go ahead and power. Now, we can also grab a shaft and place it on the back and place the shaft on the front. And then we're going to grab our gantry shafts, place that one in front of this shaft, and then just place the rest of them by just holding right click. And you can actually have more than these guys depending on how much you would like to extend your poles out, but I'm just going to go ahead and use 20 for this video. But basically, the longer this is, the longer that your machine will move. Now, once we do that, we also want to take a gantry carriage, and we want to place it on the last pole of the gantry shaft so that it connects to this rope pulley. And then we also want to take super glue the top of the gantry carriage, and place down a large cogwheel so that connects with this cogwheel. Now, just some quick reasoning behind all of this craziness is with our gantry shafts, as I went over in one of the What's Doing Create videos that I did, if you send a redstone pulse or anything through a gantry shaft, it will actually go ahead and send the power through your gantry carriage into whatever you would like to do. And we're using these cogwheels to transport the power into the rope pulley to then lower the mechanism. Then it comes back up, and then this machine will eventually tell it to move, hey, 3 blocks forward, pause, continue, and so on. All right, so the next part is going to be the bane of my existence, good old redstone. So I'm going to go ahead and just kind of go over this as slow as I possibly can for anyone else that struggles with redstone. So what I've done here is we have our last gantry shaft. We've gone 1, 2 blocks out and built up a single block. And just make sure that they're whole blocks. Don't use glass or anything like that. Just use like sandstone, anything solid. We're going to place a redstone torch here. 2 blocks over, I've done the same thing. Another redstone torch, so it's activating this gear shift. Now, we're also going to grab a redstone repeater. We're going to go ahead and place him so that he is facing towards this other redstone torch. We're going to go behind him, and we're going to place 1, 2, 3 redstone dust. We're going to grab a powered toggle latch, place that so it's facing the redstone dust. Then we're going to place 1, 2, 3 redstone dust just like this. And then we're going to grab a adjustable repeater, place this guy so he is facing towards our powered latch, and then we're going to scroll wheel this up to be 5 seconds. Now, if you adjust this value and you adjust the speed of your machine, you can go ahead and fool around with this to make your machine faster or slower, but we're going to be running our machine at 16 RPMs off of a water wheel, so 5 seconds, 16 RPMs is kind of the best shenanigans for that. If you speed your machine up, you're going to want to drop this amount of seconds. But basically, we're also going to place down a single redstone dust. We're going to place down a pulse repeater, aiming with the torch facing this redstone dust. We're going to place down 1 redstone link. Then we're going to place down a piece of redstone, grab a powered toggle latch, place it so the torch is facing the opposite direction, where we're going to place 1, 2, 3 redstone dust connected to this sandstone. Over here, we're going to place 1 redstone dust and another redstone link. Next, we're going to take our frequencies, and what you have to do is look at this frequency redstone link that we have right here. It's orange for me, and we're going to set that to this frequency right here. So I'm going to go ahead and select that, and then the other one's just going to be the other frequency that we've set up. Now, you just want to shift right-click on both of these guys. That'll make them receivers. You'll see some redstone start to do some things, and that means that we're now just ready for our power. So all we're going to do is set up a simple water wheel, and I built this glass contraption. All it's going to do is hold the water wheel and spread water over it, so you don't have to panic too much. We're going to place a shaft off of this shaft that we previously placed. We're going to place a rotation speed controller against this and turn it to negative 16. I know I said we're doing 16 RPMs. This is the opposite direction because it flips in the rotation speed controller, and we want it to go into the clutch, turning clockwise, which we'll see in a moment. We're going to place a large cogwheel into this rotation speed controller. And then up here, we're going to place a water wheel down with the spokes facing in the correct direction and a water bucket. And if you've done this correctly with the speed controller and everything, you should see it's turning clockwise and it is set at negative 16 RPMs. Now, if we have done this all correctly and it's all set up, all we have to do is flick our lever and our machine should start working. So you're going to see that it's going down currently. It is now mining basically our platform that we had previously. It's going to go all the way down to bedrock, which we'll give it a moment to do so. You could see that our blocks that we wanted to stay are still up here. And then once it goes ahead and mines all the way down to bedrock, it sends a signal via the observer, and then it continues to mine down. Cool thing to kind of talk about really quick is this observer is basically sends a signal as soon as it gets to the bottom, because it's an entity while it's moving, and then it's not an entity when it gets to the bottom. So that's how it detects things. But there you go. You can see our machine is up and running. I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, drop a like, feel free to subscribe. Let me know in the comments if you were during the live stream of me screwing up and fighting with this machine. I might do more of this more often, of kind of showing the behind the scenes during a live stream and then making a tutorial afterwards, because there's a lot of hours that go on behind the scenes for my tutorials, and I think kind of having an interactive chat to help me out is pretty awesome. I just want to say thank you guys so much once again. We just hit 7,000 subs when I went ahead and made this video, so who knows where we're at now. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys all in the next one.